There are two on polio that I'd like to bring your attention to. As you know, polio vaccination recommendations have changed as a result of the oral vaccine and the fact that in the developed world where people are very well vaccinated, the risk of vaccine-associated polio really became unacceptable. So there are two studies that address the issue of the shedding of the oral polio vaccine. 622 is a study from Zimbabwe that compared HIV-positive and HIV-negative infants for shedding a vaccine, and it's a remarkable study. It's really, to my understanding, the first study that has really shown much more significant shedding from HIV-infected infants than HIV-negative infants. And the thing that really suggests a mechanistic explanation for this actually is that the shedding was most pronounced after the third dose of the vaccine, really suggesting that these children do not make a sufficient immune response to control the replication of the virus. Presentation 623 has a more rosy outlook. This is a study that was done in Mexico where the inactivated polio vaccine has been rolled out. And it shows fairly encouragingly that a relatively short time after the rollout of this vaccine, that the reduction in oral polio of the OPV strains was removed. They didn't find it in sewage, and they found many fewer cases in kids. So it really calls out the world for the shift to the inactivated polio vaccine. These issues are grappling with the effort to harness the pneumococcus, which, as you know, has presented, it's been a great victory with the conjugate vaccine, but the conjugate vaccine clearly unmasked the potential of this organism to come back with different coats. And so the late breaker is looking at its ongoing prospective study of invasive pneumococcal disease and shows the news that the vaccine, so the newly added serotypes that they look for were reduced in incidence in the year since the introduction of the vaccine. However, two non-vaccine serotypes occurred in really, I thought, rather high incidence, serotype 33F and 15. So this underscores the continued good news, bad news issue with the pneumococcal vaccine. The presentation 655 looked at native Alaskans who were at unusually high risk for invasive pneumococcal disease and found a very good reduction in children for the additional serotypes. The point I want to underscore from this is that this study has shown, as others have shown, that herd protection does not extend to immunocompromised individuals. So that was illustrated in this study as well.